Friends, I'm going to talk about the immediate infection after nailing or plating. This is the one which is neglected by many. My focus on infection occurring in first 10 days of the close fracture operated upon, and such infection should not have ended in disaster if the operating surgeon was alert during those first 10 to 12 days of surgery. My ritual in the workshop which I do, what do you do if there is a fever 4 to 5 days after the operation? And the answers are, change to higher antibiotics, see the dressing if any pus, and probe a needle and see if any pus. All are wrong. This will never happen. If you're waiting for the pus, it's too late. You can never really wait for the pus to happen. You have already missed the boat. No blood tests are useful to detect an immediate infection after the operation in first 4, 5, 8 days. ESR is always high. Raising C-reactive is suggestive, not confirmative. Procalcitonin is also of a doubtful value at times. WBC and all these are not really decision-making investigations. They lull you to sleep. So I feel it's not really worth depending on the investigation. If it shows infection, then only you go down. Probably will miss the bus very often. What is the warning signs? Fever after 3 to 4 days. Pain increases, which has subsided after initial post-operative pain. Pain increases, which has subsided after initial post-operative pain. This is the most important sign which you should guide you that this is probably the post-op infection. Increased pain, it is the infection unless and until proved otherwise. Increasing pain over the 6 hours is more suspicious. The pain which has subsided immediately after 1 or 2 days, and if the pain starts increasing, that is the one which is most important. Fever also may be, which could be unnoticed or suppressed by analgesics. Increased pain after 3 to 4 days, this I feel is the main sign. Do not sleep over increased pain. Immediate X-ray, if the hardware is intact and still there is increased pain, it is infection. We try to explain it that the patient has a low capacity or the epidural is stopped or any of these other reasons for this pain, but the increasing pain is never because of all these things. Best time to do anything is tonight, not tomorrow morning. Do not postpone till morning. Delay will harm. It will never help. Next day's commitment will not let you take the patient first thing in the morning. What do you do for a suspected infection? If you feel the pain is increasing, I feel the only treatment which is explore. Go down earliest on suspicion of an infection. Open up the whole wound layer by layer. Cut all the doubtful devitalized muscles. If any bone without the soft tissue, do not fall in love with the bone, excise it. Wash out the wound, jet lavage, and resuture. Best chance of a normal course if opened early, 15 days is the outermost. Keep stable fixation. Make the fixation stable if it is not stable. I would rather open up unnecessarily at times than dither whether to open or not to open. Start higher antibiotics immediately after a culture is taken. After the culture, the results may need to change. 6 weeks of appropriate antibiotics is the one which has been asked for. 3 weeks IV and 3 weeks oral is more practical. What is the prophylactic antibiotic protocol? We have just now already discussed, but in my 5-star hospitals where I work, I give 1.5 day, some people give 1 week, some people give till the sutures are removed 10 days, till the patient goes home or the RMO is really confused about this. Recommendation, we already discussed appropriate antibiotic 30 minutes before the skin cut, before the tunica elevation. 24 hours or maximum is the 48 hours or 36 hours is antibiotic is the highest. Why not more? Argument our OT is not ideal and hence 10 days. What happens in 10 days course? Infection is suppressed. When the antibiotics are stopped, the bug revealed their strength. After the 10 days of antibiotics, when it is stopped, if the infection has occurred, the bugs are not dead. They start becoming active and the pus after a few days after reaching home. Acute symptoms do not come and hence no early warning signs. Indian practice, if the patient gets fever, post-op and the infection, how do you face it normally as a surgeon to patient? These implants have given reaction to you. This is the standard one. You are allergic to these implants and that is why you pain. We bombard with higher antibiotics and suppress his symptoms. Patient is now fever-free, happy and pays us and goes home. Patient is satisfied for a while. What we have done is, we have temporarily satisfied the patient but created one more unhappy patient. Later, one non-curable infection comes over in few months' time and golden chance of win-win situation is lost. So never, never, never start an antibiotic to suppress the infection if it is suspected. Say whatever you want to tell patient as a business strategy, allergy, not suitable, etc., etc. But act scientifically and open up. You will win in a long term also. Do not sleep over. Best chance to turn the tide if infection occurs is first few days. What is orthopedic post-op round for 3 days? It's a social hello. The real round is 4th, 5th, and 6th days, and that is pain or a fever. If one has done plate, open up the whole area which you have traveled. If one has done nailing, then clean up all the open wounds, point of entry and locking screw incisions. Extra is from point of entry, pass fluid by jet lavage to clean the medullary cavity if possible. Pass a small tube by the side of the nail or inside the nail till it goes through it, which gives a good lavage. And this, even if the infection occurs, it's a very low-grade infection, so it is very likely to heal up with a small discharging sinus. If one has done prosthesis, hip, open the capsule and clean debride and drain. And if it is done knee, then extra maybe change the poly for whatever worth and drain. Practical suggestion in India, my apologies to those purists who will shake their head when I say, when decided to open up on a 5th, 6th, or 7th days for suspected infection, do not tell a patient you need another operation. Second opinion will come into the picture, losing the golden chance. Second opinions mean the patient's wanting opinion. Wait, we see, what is the hurry? And another senior surgeon will latch on to the patient and may take away. Cheat. The polite way, if I can say, is polite expression is hide the word operation. Tell a patient you need dressing. We will keep anesthetic standby so you do not get pain due to the dressing, which is painful. It is ideally to be done in OT to avoid any infection. Never say you need another operation. Dressing, dressing, it is a small thing. Do all legal proper documentation and then do a dressing, a large dressing. Open up every place you had reached at the time of operation. Never a small two-stitch removal and be a peeping tom. Patient is told we had to do a good dressing and give appropriate antibiotic for 6 weeks, which may have to be changed on culture report. If you have done this, chances are nearly 100% that the patient will have a normal good outcome without alteration due to infection. On a good outcome, patient will forget that second dressing which you did. Last, at the end of the whole drama, do not charge a patient for that dressing. If you charge, he will not forget. If you don't, he will forget that dressing. Buck stops at you, then only these things can be managed. Buck doesn't stop at you, pass it on to where the buck stops. Thank you very much.